What's really important is you see where these walleye is positioned. The water's not that deep. It goes from like 5 feet to like 6, 7, 8, and then to 10, traditionally, a little bit of current. So depending on the speed of the current, the depth you're fishing, think about the size of the jigs. Too heavy and you're gonna get snagged up. Too light, you won't be bouncing on bottom. Trick is you gotta be right on bottom too, where that nasty stuff is. But these walleyes, you can tell by their color, they got belly on the bottom, like right there. Son of a gun, eh? Just gorgeous. Look at this, man. Look at this. Like, honestly. Tell me that is not fun. And they're perfect eating size. Although this one, I'll let him go. He's like maybe 12 something. But I'm not complaining. And they're cool, too. So you know that cold water is coming down. But that's Northern Ontario, man. Walleyes. Ready, buddy? You're lucky. Go on. I still got worm. Let's put it right back out. Let me check it. Chartreuse orange, and they're just sitting right in this little tail race right there. How many are in there? And is Big Mama in there? We're gonna find out.
It's that fine mix, and for this today catching these fish to 3/16 1/4 ounce are the ones you want.
There he is. And it feels, oh yeah, it feels better. Oh boy. Is that a good walleye? I think it is, folks. Oh yeah, it is. Look at him. Oh boy. Hey, look at him. There he is. Whoo! Nice walleye. Nice walleye. Sitting in a tail race below a waterfall. How can you beat that? Wow. Very nice walleye. Just knew it on the hook set. He had some girth. Loaded up the rod a bit. That's what you can get right there at Sunset Country from Cedar Lake Lodge on 105. Right there, put them in the box, and let's see if we can catch a few more, cull out the small ones, and have a great morning up here in this really wilderness setting. Gotta love Sunset Country. Thanks, walleye.
See, it's really important. Like, if you see this jig, look at a close up of it. And it's a 3/16 made by Northern Tackle Supply. A little bit of chartreuse and orange, but you can see the paint scraped off because I'm making sure I'm just bouncing this off the rocks and whatever gravel and things that are below those waterfalls. Because in springtime, when the water's flowing pretty fast, it blows down all kinds of things, rocks, trees, wood, you name it. But little things that the fish can hide behind.
Wow. Right where he should be too. Doesn't feel bad either. Oof. Are you Mr. Walleye? I think you are. You don't feel bad. Ooh boy, where are you? Oh my goodness, look at the size of that perch. Look at the size of that jumbo perch. Tell me that's not good lunch. Wow, very impressive. Look at the orange fins on these perch. Wow, you're right where you should be too. Well, you know what they say about perch? Sweeter than walleye, better than crappie. Well, by the end of today, I might have all three, and we'll do the taste test with the cameraman, my guide, and we'll see the blind taste test. Is it walleye? Is it crappie? Is it perch? Win either way.
That's very important when you're fishing for walleyes, because especially in current, the way these fish are positioned, they're sitting in that deeper water behind the falls here, like down the little tail races, and once in a while, different fish come up, maybe positioned behind rocks and logs and things like that, looking for things to get washed down, either leeches, minnows, or whatever they're eating, even crayfish or even other small little fish.
Wow, what a little spot. Might be, oh, it's a little bit better walleye. Oof. A little bit better walleye, look at him. Oh boy. Oh, look at, see that? See that? He's not a big fish, but he's a splashy fish. Nice little eater. What do you think, folks? Eat him? Keep him? I will.
So it's important sometimes to make sure, alter the different sizes of the jigs, make sure you're bouncing bottom, and make sure you got bottom contact, because that's where these walleyes are.
Nope, there's one there. See that? Back there. Oh, another smallmouth or big rock bass? No, crappie. Oh, look at this, dude. Crappie back there. Ho, ho, ho. black slab sitting in the tail race. Black crappie. I wonder why it came to the surface. I thought, you're not a smallmouth. If that's a rock bass, it's huge. Ooh, you even got crappies back here. Ho-ho, you know you're coming home, eh, boy? You taste so good. Oh, nice crappie. Love it. Let's do it.